Thank you so much for staying with Mirror Now, and we are beginning with the top focus story of the day. That remains the COVID cases that are surging as far as a record number in the country. Now, India records a meteoric rise in the COVID cases. Maharashtra continues to report the highest number of cases, 36,265 fresh COVID cases, and 13 deaths were reported in the state. In fact, Mumbai recorded a 33% hike in the daily cases as it detected over 20,000 infections and 4 COVID deaths in the last 24 hours. Over 300 healthcare workers have also contracted the virus in the maximum city.
Shifting focus to the national capital now, Delhi logged more than 15,000 cases and 6 deaths in just a day, taking up the positivity rate to 15.3% now. Out of these figures, over 400 doctors too have tested positive in the capital city. Karnataka, meanwhile, reported 5,031 fresh COVID cases and 1 death in the last 24 hours. Of these, 4,324 new cases surfaced in the city of Bengaluru, and 1 fatality was also reported in the last 24 hours. The positivity rate has shot up to 7.5%.
Now, so while the COVID infections continue to gallop across the state, the rates of hospitalization have also gone up. Now, in Mumbai, it has increased from 500 to 1,200 per day. In Delhi, the hospitalization rate has increased from 226 to 1,091 cases per day. My colleague Sandeep joins me live on the broadcast. Sandeep, these are very, very concerning numbers. Obviously, we don't intend to worry our viewers very early in the morning, but the truth stands and the numbers speak for themselves. So what is the kind of, because obviously we are obviously in the weekend, what are the kind of restrictions that we are looking at? And especially in Mumbai, which has seen a number of cases just in a matter of 24 hours.
See, as of now, yesterday there was a high-level meeting with the health minister, deputy chief minister of Maharashtra, and the NCP chief Sharad Pawar. Sharad Pawar took the stocks of things that will be done in a day or two. Now, between this, what has happened is BMC has issued an advisory for all the patients because, you know, the number of cases in Mumbai are increasing rapidly. So in that case, BMC has allowed 7 days home isolation for asymptomatic and mild symptomatic COVID-19 patients. So those who with symptoms are having comorbidity will be hospitalized on evolution of clinical symptoms, and they will be, you know, treated with advice as well. Now, BMC has also set up a dashboard in all the wards, which will be taking stock of the patients on hourly basis. They will be keeping in touch whether the patient, they will be inquiring about the health on a day-to-day basis, and the stocks of their health will be taken. Apart from that, BMC has also asked the patient to make sure to record the body temperature, the oxygen level, the pulse rate. These are the things that have been issued by BMC. So definitely it is a major concern for BMC. Now, remember Kishori Pednekar's statement, Mumbai's mayor's statement. She mentioned that if in case the COVID numbers increases more than 20,000, then they will have to think about lockdown or some more restrictions. So now the city of Mumbai has already recorded 20,000 cases. So it will be very much crucial how will BMC act now. As of now, there has been no restrictions order or no more lockdown, restriction or any kind of lockdown orders has been issued by state or by the local body out here.
Right, Asandi, thank you so much for getting us all those updates from the city of Mumbai. Let me go across to our correspondent, Alok Singh, now, who is joining us live from Delhi. Alok, good morning. It seems like Delhi and Mumbai right now are competing once again to be the worst hit metro when it comes to COVID. However, if we talk specifically about the national capital, it has logged more than 15,000 cases. Even though such a scenario is prevailing in the national capital, the Delhi government continues to be very, very positive in this entire scenario, says that all all they can do is being done, and there is no need for lockdown as of now?
Well, yes. In fact, the Delhi government is looking very much satisfactory as far as their health infrastructure is concerned, because they said that hospitalization is very less. And in fact, around 1,500 beds are occupied out of those. In fact, the arrangement of the beds are made of around 25,000. So it's a huge number. And the patients are less severe, so that is why they are looking satisfied. But from today onwards, it will be very interesting to see that how much the weekend curfew will affect the number of cases which is coming. In fact, in the national capital, 50% to 100% jump we are seeing every day. In fact, yesterday 15,000 cases came. The day before yesterday, 10,000 cases came. And before that, 5,000 cases came. So 50 to 100% jump we are seeing in past 3 days. From today onwards, the weekend curfew is being imposed. So for 2 days, the government will get the number of cases might be decreased when the counting will be done on Monday or Tuesday. So that will be interesting to see that if the lockdown or the weekend curfew is actually helping or not. So this is what the case.
All right, Arok, thank you so much for all those inputs, and also Sandeep from bringing us all the inputs from Mumbai. Meanwhile, the Union Health Ministry has listed 15 districts across the country as the emerging districts of concern, given the spike in the number of COVID-19 cases and also the positivity rate on a weekly basis. Now, 9 out of 15 districts listed by the center fall in this category of metro cities.
These districts were analyzed from December 4, 2021 to January 4. In Mumbai, the positivity rate soared from 0.67% to 17.2%. Likewise, in Kolkata, the positivity rate jumped to 44.5% from 5.9%. Other districts which feature on the list are Bengaluru, Thane, Howrah, Chennai, Gurugram, among others.
Now, Delhi continues to witness a spike in the new COVID cases. In fact, the national capital recorded over 15,000 COVID cases in the last 24 hours.
My colleague Harsha brings us this report from LNJP COVID ward in the national capital.
LNJP के कोविड कैजुअलिटी में इस वक्त मौजूद हूं, और जैसे जैसे देश में लगातार कोरोना के केसेस बढ़ रहे हैं, ऐसे में LNJP में ये बात साफ कही गई है कि 2/3 केसेस ओमाइक्रॉन के आ रहे हैं और 1/3 केसेस ही हैं जो कि डेल्टा के आ रहे हैं, और लगातार अस्पतालों पे जो वर्कलोड है कोविड कैजुअलिटी में या वार्ड में वो लगातार बढ़ता चला जा रहा है। इस वक्त अगर मैं आपको तस्वीर दिखाऊं, ये कोविड कैजुअलिटी है LNJP की। यहाँ से पेशेंट 3 जगह भेजे जाते हैं, कोविड ICU, कोविड वार्ड और एक रामलीला में जो कोविड केयर सेंटर बनाया गया है जो कि LNJP से अटैच है, वहाँ भेजे जाते हैं। ये जितने आप मरीज देख रहे हैं, ये सारे के सारे कोविड सस्पेक्टेड और कोविड के मरीज हैं जिनके सैंपल जीनोम सिक्वेंसिंग के लिए गए हैं। डॉक्टर रितु सक्सेना इस वक्त हमारे साथ हैं। रितु मैम, किस तरह से मैनेज कर रही हैं? पहले वर्कलोड कितना कम था, वर्कलोड कितना बढ़ गया है, रोज़ाना कितने मरीज हैं जो लगातार पहुंच रहे हैं?
एक्चुअली अभी कुछ हाल फिलहाल 3-4 दिन में ही काफ़ी रश बढ़ गया हमारे पास। अराउंड 70 to 80 पेशेंट्स हमारे पास एडमिशन के लिए आ रहे हैं, उनमें से कई पेशेंट होम आइसोलेशन के भी हैं जिनको हम घर पर भेज रहे हैं होम आइसोलेशन एडवाइस करके। पर ज़्यादातर पेशेंट अब जो आ रहे हैं हमारे पास वो माइल्ड ही आ रहे हैं, ये अच्छी बात है। पर कुछ जिनको कोमॉर्बिड कंडीशंस हैं या जो जिनके घर में कोई पेशेंट है ऐसे जिनको दिक्कत हो सकती है, वो इंसिस्ट कर रहे हैं कि उन्हें हॉस्पिटल में ही रखा जाए। तो वी आर कीपिंग देम इन ईदर कोविड केयर सेंटर जो हमारा रामलीला मैदान का है, या अपने हॉस्पिटल में अकॉर्डिंग टू द सिम्टम्स।
एक और चीज़ है, अभी जैसे जैसे जो बेड, दिल्ली सरकार की तरफ से कहा गया है कि हर अस्पताल में अगर 50 से ज़्यादा बेड हैं तो 40% कोविड के लिए रिजर्व किए जाएँ। ऐसे में अगर LNJP की बात की जाए, कितने बेड्स आपके यहाँ डेडिकेटेडली कोविड के लिए रिजर्व हैं?
अभी हमारे पास 650 बेड्स हैं कोविड के डेडिकेटेड, लेकिन आज ही ऑर्डर जो आए हैं उसके हिसाब से हमारे 750 बेड्स हो जाएंगे डेडिकेटेड कोविड। बट अभी हमारे पास और भी बेड्स हैं, लाइक वी कैन एस्केलेट अप टू 2300 बेड्स। तो अभी एज पर द गवर्नमेंट पॉलिसी वी विल इंक्रीज द नंबर ऑफ बेड्स।
यानी कि बेड्स लगातार प्रतिदिन बढ़ाए जा रहे हैं मामलों को देखते हुए?
हाँ डेफिनेटली, क्योंकि गवर्नमेंट पूरा मॉनिटर कर रही है, तो जैसे जैसे केसेस बढ़ रहे हैं उसके अकॉर्डिंगली पॉलिसीज बन रही हैं। जो आपने बताया कि प्राइवेट में भी जिनके पास 50 से ज़्यादा बेड्स हैं उनको अपने बेड्स रिजर्व करने के लिए बोला है कोविड के, वो इसी में रखा है कि पेशेंट को इधर से उधर भागना ना पड़े। हर फैसिलिटी में जहाँ भी पेशेंट्स देखे जा रहे हैं वहाँ एक प्रोविजन होना चाहिए कि कोविड के लिए भी डेडिकेटेड उनके पास बेड्स हों।
Meanwhile, the WHO Director General has warned against the new Omicron variant, asserting that while it appears to be less severe as compared to the Delta variant, it does not mean that it should be categorized as mild.
The UN health body noted that Omicron is responsible for the tsunami of cases being recorded across the world right now and added that vaccine equity is the key to fight the global challenge posed by the pandemic.
Vaccine inequity is a killer of people and jobs, and it undermines a global economic recovery. I call on citizens of the world, including civil society, scientists, business leaders, economists and teachers, to demand that governments and pharmaceutical companies to share health tools globally and bring an end to the death and destruction of this pandemic. We need vaccine equity, treatment equity, test equity, and health equity, and we need your voices to drive that change. Equity, equity, equity.